Does not need an introduction. We have a very talented chef. You've seen him on Chopped Canada, Dragon's Den, and Top Chef. Please welcome Dr. Vikram Vij.
Namaste.
Hello, namaste. How are you?
I'm good. Honored to be here.
Thank you for being on our set. Well, technically we're on his set today, so Spill Your Beans are at, you know, we're at Vikram Vij's set.
Yeah, it's called the My Shanti.
My Shanti,
which
yes.
Which means amongst the chaos of India, I find peace. Amongst the craziness of India, I can sit at a corner and just absolutely relax and enjoy myself. It's like going to the ghats of Varanasi, where you're just sitting there and you see bodies go by and dead dogs go by, and you just look at the water and you say, wow.
Wow, what do we get ourselves into? This is now, something caught me off guard. Did you say
doctor? Yes.
Okay, can you tell me about that?
Well, you know, it's so funny because I'm actually a chef, trained chef. But last year, SFU bestowed upon me a degree called Doctor of Law. And guess for what? For bringing awareness to a cuisine and a culture of my country that I left behind, called India. And I was so honored and humbled because it means so much. It's not just about cooking Indian food, but it's about cooking a cuisine that is, you know, so in depth of culture, tradition, spices, spirituality, and of course, you cannot have good food without lovemaking. That's why we have a billion people back home.
And counting.
Yeah, definitely. And I know that all your menu items are influenced from all over the world. So how do you combine your Canadian culture, your Indian culture, and other cultures in your food?
You know, I think I'm a sword. Like a beautiful, like a talwar, like an in Punjabi talwar.
Yeah.
You know, in Punjabi we call it kirpan. And the reason why I call myself a sword is because I'm not made with one element. My culinary journey started in India. I really got beaten and hardened in Austria. And then I kind of got sharpened and shaped in Canada. So that's what I am. I feel that I'm a sword. I can really, you know, protect, harness, take care of things, and how do you do it? Because you don't do it because it's a monetary gain. You do it because you absolutely love that focus. In Punjabi or in Hindi, there's a word called drishti. Yeah. Drishti means a focus. The Indian women wear that little bindi on the top. That means they have the third eye, and then they have that focus. That's what you need in life in order to get to be successful what you want to do it.
The third eye. Yeah, I knew the bindi had significance, but the third eye I thought of in spirituality, but in Hinduism as well, eh?
Absolutely.
Very powerful. Beautiful. Yeah. So you bring up Hinduism. We did some research on you, so we know Amritsar is a backbone and home. How did the culture of India actually influence? Is it Hindu food? Is it Punjabi food? Vegetarian food? Does that mean anything?
Yes, it does. So there is a science called Ayurveda in India, which means eating healthy through your spices. So our cumin and our cloves and our turmeric and our ginger and our garlic, they're all really healthy for you. When I was growing up in Amritsar, obviously I'm one of the very few Hindu Punjabis that were in Amritsar before the partition. And in 1984, the year Indira Gandhi attacked Harminder Sahib, that night I left India to go and come to Bombay. And what spirituality meant was that my dadi used to go to the Harminder Sahib every morning and then go to the temple every morning. So I know all the shlokas and I'm totally versed in that. As far as cuisine is concerned, I believe that spirituality is what I brought into the food. So the way you get up in the morning and do your part, or you do your puja, and that gives you that sukoon, that calmingness. What I wanted that when people ate my food, they felt the same calm, sukoon feeling of wow, somebody cooked this delicious meal for me with a lot of love and passion.
Well, I'm going to admit something, what you just said here. Like, when you're very, very full on a good meal, you can easily fall asleep. And the only place I can actually fall asleep is the Gurdwara.
Yeah.
I'll be honest. It's the one place where I can go and within 5 minutes, I can pass out.
And you know, going to langars and going to those spiritual places on Sundays meant so much to me emotionally. It gave me the strength to deal with a lot of atrocities and things that happen to you during your lifetime, that they just give you that strength to say, I am going to continue doing what I want to do and believe in it.
Yeah.
The point is to believe in what you do. We serve the best food, cooked by the best chefs, cooked by the best Indian women. Is it perfect? No. Is it delicious? Yes. Is it made with love and utmost care? Yes. And that's what we want to showcase.
So is that how you stay calm? Are you very spiritual? Do you pray often? What do you do to stay calm during challenging situations?
Well, one of my things that I do is I love going for walks. So I love going for a walk around the water. That calms me down a little bit. I don't go to an organized religion. It's not like I go to the Gurdwara every Sunday or anything else like that. But if I'm at a Gurdwara, if somebody says, you know, we are having a part at home, come over. I love going and sitting there and thanking God for what I have gotten and received in my life. And I'm an extremely proud Indian first, then a religious person.
Spirituality.
So spirituality comes from me, from a nation that I left behind, a country that I left behind, not just a Hindu or a Punjabi or a Muslim or a Sikh or an Asai.
You just made my hair stand up. That's kind of what we're all about and what we want to do. So hearing that from you is, as you said, we're not talking to a celebrity here, we're talking just another fellow human being. I love how you can talk openly about this.
Yes. Yeah.
There's nothing called a celebrity. Celebrity is bullshit. You know why it's bullshit?
Why is it?
Because you go to school to become a chef, you should be called a chef.
Exactly.
You go to school to become a doctor, you should be called a doctor.
Yes.
There is no school for being a celebrity.
No.
So why are you called a celebrity?
And you know what, I actually see you more as a role model rather than, I would say, a role model or an inspiration. Because you are an inspiration to many out there, and that's what I think would be a better title.
Doing what you love to do, sharing it with other people, walking in their home, feeding their empty bellies.
Yeah, amazing.
But it's you must understand, people think of this as a business. It is a business because everybody needs to be paid and taken care of, no question about it. But most importantly, it is like to say, hey, this is where I came from. What we serve here is what Vikram Veg is on a plate. You know, born in India, so there's Indian food.
Yes.
The presentation is a little bit French, modern.
Yeah.
That's what we do. We live in Canada. And we live in a beautiful part called Canada. Why not create a plate that is Canadian and not any particular region?
Exactly, and I like that. That your food is so multicultural itself. So speaking of food, how do you create your recipes?
You know, Mai Shanti's recipe is based on my travels to India.
Okay.
I love going to India every year. It's a fascinating country. Have you been?
I have been to India, I went about 2 years ago.
And how was it?
It was beautiful. I love it. I love the food. I love the culture. I enjoy it every time.
Isn't it crazy?
It's crazy. It's very crazy. Definitely.
So when people come to me here and they say, my parking spot is like 4 blocks away from your restaurant. I look at them and say, really, dude? That's your only fucking problem in life? Get a job.
Yes.
Like, seriously. Go to India and we'll put things into perspective. And that's
First world problems.
Exactly. And what I'm saying is, how do you motivate yourself? You motivate yourself by going to different parts of people's homes, learning how to see, and say, how did you make this? Show me. Share your love. Share your passion with me. It's like a musician. A musician doesn't play music just for themselves. They play music so that they can share it with the world. An artist doesn't draw a painting so that he or she can just look at the painting. They do it because they want to share it with the world. Cooking is exactly like that. You want to share it with the rest of the world.
Well, we're going to keep cooking here, so please stay tuned with us. And when we come back, we'll get some more open-ended questions. I'm going to try and open
them
up. That's right.
Yes,
I'm going
to
try and open
them
up.
Now it's time to spill the beans.
So, yes, let's do it.
All right,
let's
stay tuned.
Let's spill some beans.